For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. The power of Hurricane Matthew that came through here last week is the same powerful that God created us. The same God that created that hurricane is the same God that came down here and died upon the cross for our sin. That same power is the power that came up from the grave 3 days and 3 nights later for our salvation. Because we are sinners. America wants the preaching of love of God and love, and that love was upon a cross upon Golgotha, the place of the skull. Calvary is where God hung and died upon the cross because we are sinners. The gospel is that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures. He was buried, and he arose again the third day according to the scriptures, because we are sinners. The wages of sin is death. We will die because we are sinners. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. We are all sinners. We will all die. We will all face God. The Bible says, prepare to meet thy God. I don't care if you don't believe in God. Prepare to meet thy God. Atheist, according to the Bible, you have a God. And you will meet him one day. Because you are a sinner. And because we are sinners, we will die. Because we are sinners is why we have hurricanes and tornadoes and death and sickness and plagues and famines and droughts and flooding, because we are sinners. You say Hurricane Matthew is a result from God? No, I say Hurricane Matthew is a result of sin. Had Adam and Eve never disobeyed God and not taken that fruit, there would be no destruction. There would be no pain. There would be no sorrow. That came after eating the fruit. That came after rebelling against the Word of God. And we are sinners. And we will die. Even a saved, born-again Christian, I am a sinner. Outside the rapture, I will die. But when I die, my sins are and have been placed under the blood of Jesus Christ. I said they have been. 1987, I received Christ as my Savior. They are today, presently, put under the blood of Jesus Christ. 1 John 1:9. He is faithful and able, if I were to confess my sins and future sins, until I die, until I am raptured, future sins can be put under the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because I'm a sinner. And all have sinned. You're a sinner. And if you have never trusted Jesus as your Savior, you are a lost sinner. And you will end up in hell as a sinner because you have rejected Jesus Christ as your salvation. For the Bible says, behold the Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world. Now, I didn't say the church of God which take away the sin of the world. I didn't say the priest of God that take away the sin of the world. I didn't say cash, check, or money order that takes away the sin of the world. I said the Lamb of God which take away the sin of the world. You've got to have a Lamb. You've got to have the Lamb. You've got to have your Lamb to be washed, to be cleansed in the eyes of God. For there is one mediator between God and man, and it's not Mary. It is the Lord Jesus Christ, a lamb without blemish, without spot, chosen before the foundation of the world, chosen to be our sin sacrifice, because we have all sinned, because we are sinners. Death is coming because you're a sinner. The wages of sin is death. And yet, the gift of God's eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. The reason for Jesus Christ is because you are a sinner. The reason Christ died is because I'm a sinner. The reason he rose from the dead is to show the power of God through Jesus over sin and death and hell. And you've got to be careful. Because Apostle Paul writes to us that there are other Jesuses, other spirits, and other gospels. You've got to have the Lamb of God which take away the sin of the world. Your sin has to be paid properly to God by God's means and no other ways. Because you are a sinner. And because you are a sinner, and we sin every day, you cannot pay for your sins. There is no menu on how much adultery costs. There is no price for theft. There is no means of cash for telling a lie. For all have sinned. Sin is sin. Behold the Lamb of God which take away the sin of the world. All sin. There is no, oh, you committed this. Oh, you're in jail for that. Oh, you have done that. No, all have sinned. We are all in the same class. We're sinners. But by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, I'm a saved sinner. What about you? There are saved sinners and there are lost sinners. Sinners that are washed in the blood of Jesus Christ, and sinners, whatever you want to do, whatever you want to believe, anything outside of Jesus Christ. Your choice. But your choice is not God's choice because you are a sinner. Because you are a sinner in the eyes of God, you need a payment for your sins. And God has only provided one payment for your sins. And Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. That's the only payment that God will and has accepted for your sins is Jesus Christ. And no other. Nothing else but the blood of Jesus cleanses. Jesus saves, and Jesus saves alone. Nothing else. No one else but Jesus. The Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world. You've got a sin condition. And whatever your sin condition is, it is terminal. You will die in your sin. You were born in sin thanks to your mother. You were a part of a sinner thanks to your father. And it goes all the way back to great-grandma Adam and Eve. You were born into it. There's only one thing you can do about it. You can burn in hell for all eternity, or you can believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved. That's your only two options. to sin in the world. That's the only way you get your sin dealt with. At the cross of Jesus Christ. And at that cross, there's no church. At that cross, there's no baptism. At that cross, there's no money. That dying thief that got saved that afternoon was never baptized. He never joined the church. He couldn't reach down into his butt to grab his pocket. But he turned to God's Son and said, "Remember me." And today, thou shalt see me in paradise. No church attendance, no baptism, only belief on Jesus Christ and repenting of his sins. And the Word of God. You say, what word did that dying thief get? King of kings, Lord of lords, Jesus, the King of the Jews. That's in the Bible. That title that Pilate wrote above Jesus is in the Bible, the Word of God. It's recorded in all four Gospels. And though I can't quote that plaque totally, it's in all four Gospels. That dying thief looked upon that and said, "That is my only hope. That is the one that I'm to depend on." And on that afternoon upon Calvary's cross, there was the Lamb of God which take away the sin of the world. And ladies and gentlemen, there was a saved sinner on that cross. He came to Jesus, believed on Jesus, and got eternal hope. And there was a lost sinner on that cross that afternoon too. And that lost sinner died and went into hell. And Jesus went into hell with my sins, walked up to that dying thief and said, "I'm the way, the truth, and the life. You can never get out of here. Satan, give me those keys of death and hell. They're mine. I've got some people I got to go visit." Walking over that gulf, he came to that repentant thief and said, "Here I am." I said, "Here I am." I'll say it again. I am. That's not me. That's Jesus. Jesus said, "I'm the water of life. I am the bread of life. I am the light." That's not your church. That's not you. That is anything but Jesus Christ. When you stand before God, for the Bible says, prepare to meet that God, and you stand at the great white throne judgment and you whip out your wallet won't be there. Where is it? You'll stand naked and condemned and guilty before the holy God that died for your sins. I'm a president of a company. That company has been destroyed and casted down and fled from the presence of the great white throne. All of this will be gone. Where's your company then? Mother Earth will tremble, pack up, and say, "I'm out of here. I am so wicked, I can't stand before the God that created me in Genesis 1. Your Mother Earth will flee before Father God. And how dare you, with your Mother Earth, put your sewage into her? Giving your mother your sewage. You're cruel. I can think of another word you're doing to your mother, but I'll be nice. I'll say sewage. But there's another word, what you're giving your mother, this is your mother. But I have something better than Mother Earth. I have something better than Mother Nature. I have Father God that died upon a cross because I'm a sinner, that he went into the grave as much as I will go in the grave if the Lord tarries. And he came out of the grave the third day, the third night, the power of the resurrection with the keys of death and hell, with the power to say, believe on me and thou shalt be saved." How about your popes? Where are they today? They're still in dirt. in heaven. There's no Methodist in heaven. There are only Bible-believing, born-again Christians. I gotta put that title with Christians because the media has ruined what Christians really are. And I'll tell you, when you say you're a Christian or you mention Christian and you think it's good, you haven't read your Bible. Because Christian in the Bible was an insult. And no Christian got offended, they took it with honor. They acknowledged those disciples and those people that got saved that you are a Christ follower. You are an imitation of that Jesus that was living, that died, that you say that was rose again from the grave. You imitate him. That was a disgrace remark to the saved, but to us it's honor. But see, the problem is, we're all sinners. All of us have broken a commandment or 13. You didn't know there were 13 commandments in the Bible, were you? I'll tell you the commandment you broke. Don't eat that fruit. I didn't eat no fruit. Grandma and Grandpa, Adam and Eve ate the fruit. And because they ate the fruit, we are sinners. Maybe a priest should yell the gospel one day. Maybe a priest should yell up and stand, Jesus saves! I am not ashamed of the gospel. You see, Grandma and Grandpa Adam and Eve disobeyed a commandment of God. And we are born in their nature to sin. So in a way, psychiatrists sort of have it right. Thanks to Mom and Dad, I am the condition I am in. We are born bald and no teeth. No reason why we cry. We come into a world from darkness into light. Cockroaches can't even stand light. We come into this world owing our parents a big debt of money. Now, where did that come from? Where did it come from mother's tears of giving birth to a child? Genesis chapter 3. Because Eve took that fruit and ate of it. And you're no different here today in 2016 on October. Because I'm telling you right now what God's telling you. You've got to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved, and you're doing the opposite of what Eve did. You won't listen. And you will not receive Christ. And you continue to go about grabbing your fruit and eating it. That's a great message for a farmer's market. You're grabbing your fruit instead of Jesus. I hope that fruit is juicy and tender because you'll get no fruit in hell. As we stand here and preach Jesus and what God has demanded for you to do by giving you a choice, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved because you're a sinner. Lady, you'll be annoying when in hell you will be in torment for all eternity because you have not turned on Jesus Christ. You wish at that moment you had heard the words and believed. We stand out here today in the love of God trying to prevent you to go to hell. It's funny, I don't see anybody leaving because we're preaching. Listen, people. Has anybody told you this week to go to hell? And we stand here to tell you not to go to hell. Why doesn't somebody ever say, go to heaven? You annoying employee I have, go to heaven. No. What's the worst thing they can think of? Hell. And we stand here with the worst thing trying to think of hell, and we say how to get out of it. See, we go contrary to the world. The world tells you to go to hell, we tell you not to. And some of you find the message offensive because you are a sinner. I have tasted of the living waters. I have eaten of the bread of life. I have partaken of the Spirit of God. I have the words of life here in my arm. I am an experience of what God can do for you. But in order for you to get the experience of God, God requires you to do something. Believe. Faith. If you're not going to come to God and say, well, let me try that. Are you just willing to try? God said, God, that let mouth man. But what if he's right? What if in his loudness he's correct? Can I try God? Is it possible that I can give God a little taste and see if I like it? Can I prove God? Or is that a sin? Can I say to God, God, that guy's been preaching week after week after week, and you know what? I'm getting a little agnostic here. I don't know. He's got a message. He comes every week. That message is the same message. That message is of hope. And he doesn't take my money like the alcohol people take my money. He doesn't steal from me like the tobacco companies steal from me. And he's offering a hope that my pills cannot give me because I got to get more pills. What does God say about you coming out and saying, let me just try you? There's a Bible thing for you trying God. And I'm not saying, oh God, you know, this fleece upon the ground, oh God, if you give me $1 million, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about you coming to God, the holy God, and say, you know what, I just don't know. Let me turn to Isaiah chapter 1. Let me say what God is saying to you, sinner. God says, come now. You may not have later. There are people this morning that woke up in eternity. They don't have this afternoon. They cannot go back and undo what they've done. They cannot go change what they didn't do. And God says, come now. Step out from those tomatoes. Get away from those watermelons and come to God. Are you going to go to hell over green beans over God? But God says, come now, Isaiah 1:18. God says, come. And yes, for some of you, maybe one of you, you're afraid to come. You want to come. Week after week, you want to come. Come! I did. The world doesn't want you. Satan doesn't want you. But God says, come now. And let us reason together. That's God speaking to you. God is saying, come now, let's you and I get together. Let's you say, you know what? I don't know about God. I'm not sure about you, God, but I'm interested. And God says, come now, let you and I get together. Let us open the Bible and get together. Now, we're not talking about worldly things. We ain't talking rapping with Jesus. My man, Jesus. I ain't talking. by the word of God alone, outside of nothing else. Come now, let us reason together, saith the Lord. That's not me. I am not going to open myself up to everybody and anybody, sorry to say. But God does. You want to talk world and sports and adulterous activity? You go about your way. I don't want to talk to you. But if you really want to meet God, you really want to reach out for God and God to reach out to you, I'll talk. I will talk Bible. I won't talk nonsense. Your sins be as scarlet. There you go. God is reaching out to you, sinner. Now, we've had plenty of mockers come. We have had many fools step up. We've had many people that hate God come up to us. But God says, come now, let us reason together, sinner. To me, I've done things wrong. God said, sinner, come. Let us reason together. So if you want to have an intelligible conversation with the street preacher here, you will have to come as a sinner seeking God. Don't walk off and say, well, he wouldn't listen to me. A sinner, you're coming to me as a fool. I don't have time for fools. Now, if you come up to me and say, really, I want to meet God, I'm the sinner you're speaking about, I'll drop this Bible, I'll turn off this microphone, I will sit or kneel with you on the ground here, I'll talk to you about Jesus. And pray while I'm doing that you believe on Jesus to be saved. If you're going to come over here angrily with your religion to try to convert me, I probably came out of your religion, and I've been converted by the one that saves, Jesus Christ. And you're just here by Satan to argue the moment, to waste God's time. Walk off. And by the way, from this day forth, I've set in my heart, you mockers, you fools, I will rebuke you openly before all people now on. So if you don't want to be put down, just keep your mouth shut and keep on talking. I'm going to preach the Bible. I'm going to let the Word of God stand, not you. I'm very great for getting the last word in. Because I'm not ashamed of the gospel because Jesus saved me. I know what it is to taste Jesus. I'm not talking about his bread and wine. I'm talking about the living Jesus. That Jesus you eat and drink is dead. I serve a risen, alive Savior that's sitting at the right hand of the Father right now looking at the Father. Do you see that guy down there? Do you see he's got the Bible? He's preaching to the people. He's telling them about us. And all the angels are, amen, glory to God. God's not turning to his son and say, son, go down there and show up in that guy's piece of toast. That's not God. God says to the Holy Spirit, reach down to those people and tell them that they're sinners. And we are all sinners. I'm sick and tired of the nonsense that people believe in religion. Jesus is in the tree. Jesus is in the toast. The angels showed up to me. And the Bible says that's all lies. If I came out here as a liar, as most of you are liars, you would pay me. If I were to set up a booth here at the farmer's market with a couch and say I was a shrink, a doctor that can fix your mind, you would pay me to try to fix your mind, which I couldn't fix your mind. But I bring to you the gospel of Jesus Christ, and you act like dumb sheep. wouldn't do that. You're mean. You have no love of God. And then you go to your penny waist preacher. I heard this guy screaming hard in the Bible.
Well, that's what some people do. We don't do that here. The hell with your prayer, pastor.
Believe on Jesus, be saved, and get the power of the Holy Spirit to go in all the world and preach the gospel. Preach to sinners, being a sinner. I'm a saved sinner. I'm going to heaven by the blood of Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world. You speak against my religion. God will speak against your religion in the great white throne judgment when he casts your religion into hell. I don't even have the power to do that. I just got the gift of sarcasticness and the big mouth to put you down. But I don't have the power to put it into hell. That's what God will do with your religion. You see, religion is man-made. Jesus Christ is God-approved. And if I've called you a sinner, for the Bible says, for all have sinned, and all have come to show the glory of God, and if religion is man-made, that means your religion is sin. And no sin can appear before God, for God said, I am holy, be ye holy. So if men are sinners, for all have sinned come to show the glory of God, and you're going to bring to God something that's man-made, and God says, be ye holy, for I'm holy, and I'm only holy, and I'm only righteous by Jesus Christ, I have Christ's righteousness. How on earth are you going to come to God and who you are? You're worm food. You're dust. God made a pile of dirt and said, I'll make man out of that. And man has sanctified himself ever since. How about giving God the glory? Are you a school teacher here? I believe in Jesus. I believe in... Why don't you give God the glory making this everything that's here instead of the Big Bang? Got a baseball stadium here. That's a god. A small g. The God of all gods, the holy God, said, come now. Let us reason together. Though your sins be as scarlet. He wants you as a sinner. Don't come up here and not being a sinner. Don't come up here or I'm going to teach him a lesson. I have been through seminary. I've got the doctorates. Officially, I'm a doctor, but I don't call myself that. And you're going to teach me? No. You see, I've got the greatest doctorate right now of all doctorates. I've got abiding in me, the comforter sent by Jesus, by God. And the Bible says he's the teacher. And what is the message today? You're a sinner. You've got a terminal illness that will cause death. You need to do something with your sins. You need to be washed in the Lamb of God, which take away the sin. What must I do to be saved? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. What did Jesus say? He said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. So in this great Christian nation, that I have rights of the Constitution, that I can't venture across the street and talk to Americans in this country, if I were to ask you, are you going to heaven? Your answer would probably be, yes, I'm going to heaven. And I were to say, well, how are you going to heaven? And if you don't give me the answer to the blood of Jesus Christ or anything that has to do with Jesus, the gospel that Christ died for our sins according to the Scripture, was buried, and arose again the said, pass by the one that said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life, and bring to me religion, bring to me cash, bring to me how good you are. Because the Bible says there's none good. So if you're to walk over and say, well, I'm a good person, I'll show you in the Bible, you're a liar. You just committed two sins. You're saying you're good and then you lied. The more you open up your mouth, the more you show how stupid you are and how much a sinner you are. And yes, that warning goes to preachers in the Bible as much as we open up our mouths. You know, when a preacher opens up his mouth, he puts his foot in it, and Romans 10 says, how beautiful the feet. You know, the Bible says that preaching is foolish. To stand out here on a sidewalk and to yell at you people. But it's foolish. And yet, it's the words of life. as a supper. And Jesus said, I will knock on the door and invite you out, and to him that comes out, I will sup with him, Matthew. Leave that booth and come to God through Jesus Christ now. Come. Says, come now. Don't wait for later. We're going to leave. And we may never come back. You may never come back. We may be here next week. You may not be. I'm not saying you're going to die, just saying I don't know. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God's eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Come, receive the gift of God, Jesus Christ, eternal life. Come. It's the free gift of God. What if I had free hamburgers? I wouldn't have enough. I had a guy one day, hey, let's have some hamburgers. It wouldn't be enough. You pigs will run off. You pigs will eat all my hamburgers for free and walk off, and then you'll come back to Jesus for more hamburgers. That's biblical. You don't even know it's biblical. I just added a piece of meat inside the bread. Actually, you know, let's make it even more biblical. I could have a bunch of flail fish up here. And you would dine on the flail fish. That's more biblical. And you would come to Jesus next week saying, preacher, where's my flail fish? John chapter 6. Any preachers hear this message, they're probably rolling on the floor laughing. I can't believe he said that. That's a good illustration, though. That illustration is free of charge. Anybody can use it. I like it. Sure can't have a hamburger with a bunch of Jewish people. Ham is not kosher. You see, I can give you everything free about Jesus, but you won't receive Jesus according to John chapter 6 because it's free. I can come up with all kinds of gimmicks, and your church can come up with all kinds of gimmicks, but you need Jesus. You need Jesus now, the Bible says, because you don't know if you have later. Behold, it's pointing unto man wants to die, but after this, the judgment. Some people say that judgment comes after death, and it's pretty close. I don't know. Can you imagine if it was so, and I'm not saying this, and I don't know, but can you imagine if you were to hear preaching by me in the Bible about Jesus Christ, you walk across this road, you get hit by a car, and you die, and you face judgment at that moment, and it's like, don't you hear him preaching now? And I gotta cast you in hell with him preaching as you died. That would be a big moron all eternity. That would be a big, you stupid idiot, all eternity. But you don't know. You may have 5, 10, 20, 50 years. You don't know. I may never get my voice back. You all be happy, but you wouldn't hear the word. I come out here with signs. See, you want the love of God, you're getting it. You're getting the gospel. That's the love of God. That's John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he told me, go ye in all the world and preach the gospel. And he told me through the scriptures, they're not going to like it. And Jesus told me too, he said to his disciples, marvel not if the world hates you. No, it hated me first. So I expect you to hate the gospel. I expect you to hate God. I expect you to hate Jesus. But I expect like at least one of you to come out. It says, suffer, allow the little children come to Jesus. There are no other missions but the Lord Jesus Christ and His shed blood upon Calvary. You're supposed to bring your children to the Calvary, to Christ, to the cross. I'm getting bold out here, people.
What's the freedom?
Signs are for Jews. I'm getting bold. I am not ashamed of the gospel. I'm not ashamed of Jesus Christ. I am glad He saved my soul. I want Him to save you. I want you to take part of Jesus Christ and be saved. I can have, it is so fun being out here for Jesus. And you don't realize how much we talk about you idiots all the time. How you will not believe in Jesus, and it's so simple. The Bible proclaims the angels only, so far as I can see, only rejoice once when a lost man believes on Jesus Christ as his Savior. Then the angels rip up and cheer and shout and glory hallelujah. You would think there's 40,000 football games going on. There's signs all around us, walk this way, walk for this cause. How about getting down on your knees and receiving Christ as your Savior for a cause? For a cause that you got a terminal illness that will cause your death called sin. Life is in the blood of Jesus Christ. And in Jesus alone, the one that said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. No man. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The only way man will get to the Father is by Jesus. You can't walk up to God in your sins. You won't walk up to God in religion. You won't walk up to God how good you are, because Jesus was good upon the cross, and He still died. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved.